So here in this video we are going to learn adjectives. So already you know well about adjectives. A quick revision of this. Adjectives are words that modify a noun or pronoun. Okay. Adjectives are words that modify a noun or pronoun. So for example, if you are talking about Sai, you know, we can say Sai is a tall boy, Sai is a smart guy. So all these tall and smart are adjectives. Okay. So when we want to compare two things or talk about similarities and differences, we use adjectives. So when we use adjectives means when we want to compare two things or talk about differences or similarities, we use adjectives. Adjectives change their form during comparison. So now itself I talked about tallest, like that we can change their form while we are comparing something. Okay, so for example, Sai is taller than Dilip. Okay, Sai is the tallest boy in the class. Sai is as tall as Harsha, like that. Okay, so very very easy part. Adjectives are words that modify a noun or pronoun. So when we want to compare two things or similar, to talk about similarities and differences, we take the help of adjectives. So adjectives change their form during comparison. Okay, so now see examples of adjectives describing people. So if you want to describe a person, so we talk about appearance, we talk about hair, we talk about personality. So while talking about appearance, we take the help of all these words. Okay, tall, slender, petite. Okay, so here petite means attractively small. So how you have to pronounce? Petite, petite. Okay, skinny, chubby, stout, obese, slim, lanky. Lanky means tall, thin, slender. Lanky means small, tall, thin, slender. Attractive, beautiful, handsome, pretty, old, young, middle-aged, feeble, stooped, lean, tattooed, flamboyant, chic. How you have to pronounce? Chic. Okay. Chic means stylish. Okay. Eclectic means wide range. Okay. Modest. So all these adjectives we have to use while talking about the appearance of a person. Tall, slender, petite, skinny, chubby, stout, obese, slim, lanky, attractive, beautiful, handsome, pretty, old, young, middle-aged, feeble, stooped, lean, tattooed, flamboyant, chic, eclectic, modest. Not chic, sorry, chic. How you have to pronounce? Chic. Okay. Eclectic, modest. Okay. Now see, while talking about hair of a person, you have to say curly, straight, wavy, bald, cropped, spiky, blonde, black, brunette, greasy, shiny. Okay. Now see, while talking about personality, you have to use all these adjectives. Adaptable, adventurous, ambitious, amiable, compassionate, clever, diligent, lazy, practical, reliable, resourceful, sensible, sincere, unassuming, witty. Okay. So, they'll ask you, describe some adjectives that talk about the appearance of a person. Then you have to mention tall, slender, petite, skinny, like that. Okay. So now see here, they have given examples of adjectives describing places. So if you want to talk about places, to talk positively about the place, you have to use all these adjectives. Ancient, attractive, beautiful, bustling, contemporary, enchanting, lively, peaceful, picturesque, vibrant. Okay, so if you want to talk something negative of the place, no, you have to say boring, creepy, crowded, deserted, desolate, okay, dull, polluted. Okay, so to talk about person, we are going to take all these adjectives. To talk about places, we are going to use all these adjectives. Okay, so here they have given it exercise for us. Complete the following sentences with appropriate adjectives from the list below. Okay, so they have given happy, bustling, reliable, vibrant, intelligent, picturesque, amiable, rude, lazy, shy. Okay, so see here, they're asking us to use these words to fill the blanks. See, first one, Radhika never completes her homework on time. She is dash. That is the question. Okay, she never completes her home on time. So we can say she is so lazy. She is so lazy. Okay, now see second one. My friend Varun is very dash. He is good at learning things. So we can say very intelligent. Okay, so Pranav rarely gets angry with people. He is dash and compassionate. So here you have to take the help of the word amiable. Amiable means friendly. A-M-I-A-B-L-E, amiable means friendly. Okay, now see, Geeta is dash but her sister is outgoing. So here outgoing means she socializes with others in a easy manner. So here her sister Geeta is not like that. So we have to say Geeta is shy but her sister is outgoing. Okay, now see, the science teacher was very dash. All her students passed the examination with distinction. So the science teacher was very happy. Okay, the science teacher was very happy. Why means all her students passed in her examination with distinction. Okay, so people who push others in a queue are dash, rude. Okay, people who push others in a queue or dash means they are rude. Okay, the dash old town with ancient churches and wide streets is popular with the tourists. Okay, the picturesque. Okay, now see next one. The answer here is picturesque. Okay, now see, the markets in Malaysia are dash. It is better to shop in places where locals buy. Bustling means so lot of people will come and they'll create a lot of disturbance. That is bustling. Okay, so if we go to shopping mall, no, and so here we can see that kind of bustling crowd. Okay, so now see next one. The city's dash culture is famous throughout India. So here vibrant, colorful. Okay, so Veena is very dash. Everyone counts on her. Reliable. Okay, so like that we'll get questions in examination. Okay, so now they have given another exercise. Okay, write sentences with opposites of the words filled in the above blanks. Okay, to fill all these blanks, we took the help of lazy, intelligent, amiable, and then shy, happy, rude, picturesque, bustling, and then vibrant, reliable. So now we have to know the opposites of all these words and we have to write sentences. Okay. So, what is the opposite of lazy? Lazy opposite word, active. Lazy opposite word, active. Okay, he is an active person. We can say like that. He is an active person. He is an active person. So, now see, what is the opposite of intelligent? Dull. Okay, he is a dull boy. Okay. Okay, so amiable means friendly. Okay, opposite word hostile, not friendly. Okay, hostile also we can say in pronunciation, hostile only. So we have hostile atmosphere with Pakistan people. Okay, not friendly atmosphere with that people. okay. Shy opposite word bold. Okay, he is a bold boy. He is a bold boy. Okay, happy opposite word unhappy. Okay, the teacher is unhappy. Why? Means many of the students failed in her subjects, in her subject. The teacher is unhappy. Why? Means many of her students failed in the examination. Okay, so now see, rude opposite word polite. Okay, so they are very polite. They are very polite. Okay, picturesque opposite word ugly. Okay, that is an ugly town. That is an ugly town, we can say. Okay, bustling, idle. The place is now idle. No one comes here. The place is idle now. No one comes here. Okay, so now itself we learn what is the opposite of lazy? Active, intelligent, dull, amiable, hostile, shy, bold, happy, unhappy, rude, polite. Okay, bustling, idle. Bustling, idle. Okay, vibrant, opposite word dull. Okay, now it's a dull area. Okay, it's not that colorful. Okay, reliable. Okay, so many people are reliable, but many people are unreliable. We can't count on them. Okay, like that you have to write. Is it clear? So regarding adjectives, you may get what are adjectives, give examples. So to describe a person and place, what kind of adjectives you are going to use. Like that you will get a question, or they will ask you to fill the blanks with adjectives. Okay, is it clear? So adjectives I completed. In my next video I will explain some other topic. Thank you.